Hi, in this video, we'll go over how to create an incident and save it to the system. First, click Incidents in the top navigation bar, then click Create Incident. This will take you to the Create Incident form. To start off, we need to enter some key information about the incident. We'll first need to enter an incident number, so I'll just put in some random incident number. Then we need to choose the date on which the incident occurred. If you click within this incident date field, it'll bring up a date picker. Go ahead and navigate to the particular date in which the incident occurred. So I'll just choose a random one here. You can also enter the incident date manually. So let's just set it to December 1st, 2020. For now, let's leave the exposure number as it is. If you're a state or fire department user, this field should be grayed out and disabled. So let's not worry about this. Let's leave the station field blank. And now we have to choose the fire department that was associated with the incident. If you click within this field, it will bring up what's called a code lookup menu. In this menu, you can navigate throughout all the fire department groups to select the particular fire department that was associated with the incident. If you click on one of the triangles here, it should expand the fire department group to show its child fire departments or fire department groups. In this case, I want to select the Lexington Fire Department, which has an FDID of 67800. Let's go ahead and click on it, and it will populate this field. Note that I could have also just entered in the name of the fire department manually. So let's type Lexington, and you can see that the menu was automatically narrowing down to the fire department that I wanted. I also could have just typed the FDID, so 67800, and again, it will bring me to that fire department. Once you're done filling in the required fields marked by this asterisk, go ahead and click the Save button to actually save the incident to the system. After saving the incident, you should see this success message, incident has been created in the database. However, you'll also see this data validation error message, as well as a line for each field that is required. This is because we only saved the key information for the incident. If you go down further into the page, you'll see many new fields have opened up. What you see here is the complete incident form. All the fields that are outlined in red or have a red asterisk next to them means that they're a required field. You need to fill in all the required fields of this incident form with appropriate values before this incident can be considered valid. In this video, we learned how to create an incident and save it to the database. In another video, we'll go over how to actually resolve these data validation errors by editing this incident form.